Happy Mercedesing, guys. In this video, I'm going to be speaking about the breather hoses, about the ventilation. If any of my videos helped you repair your car, then please hit the button thanks. If you, yeah, you, want to be the first one to watch my videos as they're fully uploaded, then become a supporter of the channel. And if you want to watch the service manuals, then become a donor. And if you would be kind, please, to support my Patreon, then here is the link to that site, and see you there also. Thanks. Why? At the beginning, I would like to say that this is going to be the last video in this year. So I would like to wish you Happy New Year, all the best, as I have already told you, for the Christmas, and see you next year. So, why am I doing this video? Well, I have to admit you guys that I'm a bit lazy. I would say young and tasteless. And now I'm just young. So there were many of you who complained that it wasn't clear something in the video, and the music that was too loud, and I really was at my beginning then. Now I have over 300 videos on the channel, and now I'm going to repeat that video out of that reason. Because now I think that you're going to get the point. Now I'm going to show you everything. So then there were just pictures and something. This is here, this is here. Now you will see everything. Once again, before I go to this video, best wishes and see you next year, my ladies on the channel. Mwah! Kiss you all. At first, we have this part here, as you can see, which goes from the idle valve to the engine. And that's this part here, as you can see. Afterwards, we have this small part, the connecting one, and that's this part here. And afterwards we have the last one, let me show you, which is this part here on the engine. As you can see here on this picture, you have here this part which goes to the vent line from the fuel pressure regulator. And at the end, we have the main part, which you can see always on your car, which is visible. And the whole assembly looks just like this, as you can see. The visible part, the one entering the engine, now here the connection for the small part, and then the connection for this one, for the last one. And as you can see, just look what some genius did. Just look at this. He used the tape, and the price of this part is symbolic. And now I will give you the reference numbers for all these three connecting parts. That's for M102 engines. This is an empty table. Watch now the magic happening. These are our contestants in the whole game, as you can see here. Let's start with the reference numbers I promised you I'm gonna give you. The first one, 12094-2587. This is the one from the air filter housing. Number two, 12094-2187. Now this one.
Hi, hi. Wow. Wow, 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 wow. What is your number? So my number is
12094-1887. The last one, this is for M102 engines. For M103 engines, it looks a bit different. It's L-shaped because the M103 engines do not have this hole here, but they have it here. It's here. And then the one part going to the idle control valve then is different. That's why it has to, because the idle control valve is located on the other place. But this one, which ate my liver, 12094-4882. And we have this part, the rubber boot. So look, usually this part has cracks here, 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 somewhere. But look, look at this one. It's so soft. Look, this is how it is supposed to be. When this part is bad, then you will have either detonation, either your car won't start, or you will have vacuum leaks, increased RPM. Look how soft it is once again. Let's say it. Look. Comparing to this part. Ha ha! Look, look once again. Boom! This part goes underneath. Under this part. Under this unit, when you flip it over, it has to go here, because that's the part you don't see. It goes just like this. Now here, you have a plastic fitting, and then this part comes here. The second part of it goes into the ICV, right? Here, just like this. Why am I telling you this? Why am I showing you all this? Do you see this marks here? That's from the hose clamp. And it's not supposed to go there. For all of you who are driving on LPG or are forced to drive on LPG and have detonations, what can occur is that there is a plastic part here, as I repeat, and this thing goes here. It goes just like this. Now, when you have detonations, because of the lean mixture, then what detonation does, it actually forces this part to just unplug like this. And then there is no way you can start the car. And there was some genius. Look at this. This is rock hard. He, in order to tighten this part, not to have detonations, to eliminate them, he put the hose clamp here. It's a real wonder that he didn't damage the plastic part. And there is no way you can start your car. And that's what I wanted to show you and to tell you in that video. So let me show you. This is the ICV. This is that part. The second part goes here. Here. This is what you see there. And then this part. And then you see this part. And that's everything you can see there. Now, here, let me show you these two. You see this part here. Look. Look. And that's, there is a part here with that little male stuff. Let's say it like that, which goes from the fuel pressure regulator. And this is the second part. So this is the assembly. This is what you don't see. And now, for all the beginners on Ke-Jetronic, this is the throttle. This is not this thing. This is not the throttle. On Mercedes cars, you don't see this thing. I'm going to show you why. This is why. Observe. This one, which ate me for years, here, and this thing goes atop of this. Here. And that's how it is supposed to be. By the way, here you have one clamp, which you're gonna keep when you remove everything, if you have to remove this thing. And let me give you just the reference number for the rubber boot. It says 102-141-0990. And it's a bit different for M103 engines. I'm gonna show you that one also. If you need the reference number for the throttle position switch, it says 006-545-1824. So these are on Mercedes cars rubber parts where vacuum leaks can be created. Look, nothing must be cracked, torn. Nothing must be stiff. Like this one, look. Or like this one. This one is, let's say it, more or less okay. But this one, look at this. Nothing like that. as well as the rubber boot. And those were the breather hoses on a Mercedes car. Well, now I hope that you could hear me, that the music was not too loud, and see you in the next one. So, if you liked this video,
please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified when we post new videos.
Then, I would kindly ask you not to hit the button skip ad. That is going to help me a lot. And till some next one, happy Mercedesing. Bye.